Greetings of the day. Today we are going to present sessional based assignment part B for the subject metrology and quality control. And the topic for this presentation is roundness and methods for measurement of roundness. Next is roundness and methods for measurement of roundness. Basically, metrology is a branch of science and it deals with the study of measurement, and basically it also deals with the geometric shapes. So geometric shapes are classified as straightness, flatness, squareness and roundness and many others. So basically we will be focusing and more emphasizing on roundness in this PPT and their methods of measurement. Content. So this is the following content, starting from introduction to different methods and then engineering applications and lastly the conclusion. Introduction. First of all, we will talk about the basic meaning of roundness. So roundness can be defined as the measure of how closely the shape of an object approaches that of a mathematically perfect circle. Roundness can also be defined as the radial uniformity of work surface measured from the center line of the workpiece. Now roundness applies in two dimensions, such as the cross-sectional circles along cylindrical object such as a shaft or a cylindrical ruler for a bearing. Next term is sphericity. Sphericity is related to the spheres which are in three dimensions. Also, a smooth ellipse can have a small roundness or low roundness if its eccentricity is large. Next is ISO definition of roundness, that is based on the ratio between the inscribed and the circumscribed circles, that is the maximum and the minimum size for circle that are just sufficient to fit inside and to enclose the shape. The next term is error of circularity or out of roundness. It can be defined as the radial distance between the minimum inscribing circle and the maximum inscribing circle which contains the profile of the surface, such as a section perpendicular to the axis of rotation. Now the circular parts not only depend on the diametrical tolerance but also on the geometrical accuracy. Lastly, the characteristics of roundness greatly depends upon the method of generation. Causes of out of roundness. So it can be defined as the greatest distance from the actual cross-sectional surface to the surrounding circle of points as shown in the figure. Also, out of roundness gauges are used to check internal and external cylindrical surfaces. The various sources of out of roundness may be clamping distortion, spindle runout, presence of dirt and chips on clamping surfaces, erratic cutting action, inadequate lubrication, poor alignment of centers, heat and vibration, excessive feeds, poor bearing in the spindle and many more. So the next is how to find the value of out of roundness. For that, reference circles are used. First is least square circle. So the circle which is shown in the figure represents the average value of all the peaks and valleys of the profile. It is the sum of squares of sufficient number of equally spaced radial ordinates measured from the circle to the profile which has the minimum value. Now the center of such circle is known as least square center, LSC. The value of out of roundness here is the radial distance of the maximum peak from this circle P plus the distance of the maximum valley from this circle V, that is P plus V gives the value of out of roundness. Other reference circles for finding the value of out of roundness are: the first one is the minimum zone or minimum radial separation circles. So these are two concentric circles that are just enclose the profile and which have minimum radial separation as shown in the figure. Now the center of such circle is termed as minimum zone center, and the value of out of roundness is the radial distance between the two circles. The next is maximum inscribed circle. Here it is the largest circle that can be drawn inside the profile without cutting it as shown in the figure. The value of out of roundness is specified as the height of the largest peak above the circle. The last is minimum circumscribed circle. Here it is the smallest circle that will completely enclose the profile without cutting it. And the value of the out of roundness here is the distance of the lowest valley from this circle. Different types of irregularity of circular part. The error of circularity of cross section can be classified by oval, lobing, and no specific form. First of all, ovality can be defined as when there is some difference between the major and the minor axis, as shown in the first figure. Now, lobing. Lobing is particularly difficult to avoid in many machining operations, such as especially grinding, centerless grinding machining. And when it is defined as when there is a deviation from roundness of a product which is produced on a centerless machine, it is difficult to achieve because even when it is perfectly ground, the stresses at the point of contact get relieved and there is a formation of lobes. So it can be said that it is an unintentional form of error from a centerless grinding operation.
So moving forward, now we will discuss about methods for measurement of roundness. The most commonly used method of measurement of roundness is using V-block and dial indicator, roundness measuring machine, and bend center method. First off, V-block and dial indicator method. So it is a very simple and quite commonly used method. The V-block is placed on the surface plate and the workpiece to be checked is placed upon it. A sensitive dial indicator is firmly fixed in a stand and its feeler is made to rest against the surface of the work. The work is rotated against the diameter to be checked and the dial indicator records any variation in dimension due to out of roundness. This method basically converts the diameter measurement to a chordal height variation and presents a new set of measurement peculiarities which are dependent upon the included angle of the V-block. The number of lobes present on the circumference of the workpiece can also be measured by this method. We will discuss how we can do that later on. So, plotting a polar graph. Polar graph is a representation in which we get the actual shape of the workpiece. So, first of all, we will make 12 equal spaced markings at an angle of 30 degrees each to each other on the face of the workpiece on which we have to measure the roundness. Then we will bring the dial indicator in contact with the workpiece and we will carry out the reading on the indicator for each of the 12 markings which we have made on the surface. We will carry out this procedure 2-3 times and we will take out the average value for each of the 12 readings so we can get more accurate reading. So, for plotting a polar graph, first of all we will need to draw a circle of diameter which is 4 times the maximum reading. And then we will draw a second concentric circle with smaller diameter and we will use this surface as a reference. We will make two markings with equal angular spacing towards the outer circle. Now we will plot the value of 12 markings on this line and with a freehand curve we will plot the outline and the closed figure obtained is the rough representation of the workpiece outline. So now calculating the number of lobes. We will turn the workpiece around when it is in contact with the dial indicator and the number of times the indicator pointer deflects will give us the number of lobes on the surface of the workpiece. So if you want to calculate the actual value or the actual outline of the workpiece, we will find the radial distance between the minimum circumscribing circle and the maximum inscribing circle and take the average. Now we will divide it with k, which is a constant and it's dependent on the type of V block we have chosen and also on the size and shape of the workpiece for which we are measuring the roundness. And we will divide it with k and we will get a constant value which will give us the error value. So now we will use the error value to correct the rough outline and find the limitation of the V block. The accuracy depends on the V-block angle. So, we have got variety of V-blocks available in the market with different angles. So, the accuracy of our reading will change when we change the angle of the V block. So it is necessary to select the angle of V block which is quite suitable for the type of workpiece that we are handling. So the accuracy will depend on this parameter. The second is the misalignment of the dial indicator with the surface of workpiece. A dial indicator will work with best accuracy when it is in a vertical surface, in a vertical plane to the surface of our workpiece. So sometimes when we are using the dial indicator and we're touching the tip with the surface of workpiece, we are not correctly aligning it with the vertical plane of the surface of workpiece. So it has to be kept in mind, and it can lead to different readings. The third is that there needs to provision of a leaf spring, so it can protect the reading of the dial indicator. Dial indicator is very sensitive instrument, can take very different deviation on the surface, and it can turn it into a large reading on the indicator. So we have to protect it because there is roughness on the surface of the workpiece and there is a different type of wave on the surface. So the waviness will cause the dial indicator to move upward or downward depending on the shape. So leaf spring will try to dilute that problem and protect the reading of dial indicator. Second is roundness measuring machine. This is a very high precision method in which the spindle is attached with a micro indicator which is rotating around a fixed workpiece. So limitation of V block is eliminated by this method. So we can have two different type of setup for this machine. One is in which the spindle is attached with a micro indicator and it is rotating around a fixed workpiece. So and the other method is a setup in which we can get even higher accuracy when we are rotating the workpiece and keeping a fixed spindle with in contact with the edge of the rotating workpiece. So how can we get the roundness by this method? So the deviation from the surface are measured by the micro indicator and they are transferred to a stylus which amplifies the irregularities measured by the micro indicator, and it traces it on a polar graph and we get the outline of the workpiece. We can get a higher accuracy of the polar graph plot when we use the setup in which there is a workpiece rotating, as the waviness of the workpiece will be superimposed upon the profile of the job when the workpiece is rotating, and we will get an even amplified polar graph plot in that case. Now the characteristics of the roundness measuring machine. So this method is more accurate because it gives a record of the exact profile of the job which is made automatically, and thus the waviness is also superimposed on the profile of the job. A permanent polar chart record is usually provided and the method leads itself to standardization. So we can now use this method because it is a very accurate method and it amplifies the outline in form of a polar graph. The stylus is a very important instrument here because it is the difference between the V block method and this method in terms of accuracy. It is the main factor which leads this method to be much more accurate than the previous method. So this sophisticated machine has the provision to check concentricity, roundness, alignment, squareness, parallelism and the flatness of our component. So now we will talk about the bend center method. So bend center method is the third type of method by which we can find out the roundness of the workpiece. In this method, bend centers and the precision mechanical indicator such as dial gauge, air gauge or electronic indicator may be used to measure out of roundness of a workpiece on a radial basis. The accuracy of the center is however affected by the shape and angle of the centers between which we are holding the workpiece and the center holes, and the lubrication of center is also a parameter when it comes to judging the accuracy of this method. So now let's talk about the engineering application of the roundness. So we have discussed all the theoretical points till now, that about the terms and the definition, and also about the methods by which we can measure these parameters. So now let's talk about how we can apply them in real life and what is the significance in real life as well. So one of the most fundamental important form for engineering component is that there is circular cross section. So circular forms arise in many applications, particularly in bearing shaft, such as rotating shaft, and even in ball bearings. The measurement of out of roundness is an extremely important assessment to be carried out by the manufacturer. For example, a rotational bearing whose components are not accurately round will tend to be noisy and it will be likely to fail prematurely. So therefore, accurate roundness measurement is very vital for ensuring the correct functioning of such parts. Conclusion. So we can conclude that roundness is a very important geometrical parameter to consider while we are checking the dimensions of the component. Geometrical tolerance of roundness is very critical in some applications, and it can lead to failure of the component and eventually the whole mechanism if we don't keep in mind the accuracy. So a manufacturer must always keep in mind the precision of by which he manufactures the product, and also he has to ensure maximum accuracy of this parameter to ensure the smooth functioning.
I have attached all the references here which we used for making this presentation, and thank you for watching our presentation video.